Anatomy of the eye. The eye is an organ of sight and is located on the orbital cavity. It is almost spherical in shape and about 2.5 centimeters in diameter. The bony walls of an orbit and the fat protect the eye from injury, and structurally the two eyes are separated by some of the activities are coordinated so that they normally function as a pair. The structure of the eye. The eye has three layers of tissue in the walls. The outer fibrous layer, which is composed of the sclera and the cornea. We have the middle vascular layer, or the uveal tract, composed of the choroid, ciliary body, and the iris. Then we have the inner nervous tissue. This nervous tissue is composed of the retina. The structures inside the eyeball include the lens, aqueous fluid, and vitreous body. Let's look at the sclera and the cornea. The sclera, or the white of the eye, forms the outermost layer of the posterior and lateral aspect of the eyeball and is continuous anteriorly with the cornea. This sclera consists of a firm fibrous membrane that maintains the shape of the eye and gives attachment for the extrinsic muscles of the eye. Anteriorly, the sclera continues as a clear transparent epithelial membrane known as the cornea. Light rays pass through it to reach the retina. And the cornea is convex anteriorly and is involved in reflecting light rays to focus on them on the retina. Choroid. The choroid lines the posterior 5/6 of the inner surface of the sclera. It has a very rich blood supply and deep chocolate brown in color. And when light enters the eye through the pupil, it stimulates the sensory receptors in the retina and then absorbed by the choroid. The ciliary body is an anterior continuation of the choroid, consisting of the ciliary muscle and the secretory epithelial cells. The ciliary muscle acts like a sphincter. And the lens is attached to the ciliary body by the radiating suspensory ligaments, which look like the spokes of a wheel. Contraction and relaxation of the ciliary muscle fibers, which are attached to these ligaments, control the size and thickness of the lens. The epithelial cells secrete aqueous fluid into the anterior segment of the eye. The ciliary body is supplied by sympathetic branches of the oculomotor nerve, that's the third cranial nerve. And its stimulation causes contraction of the ciliary muscle and accommodation of the eye. The iris. The iris is a visible color ring at the front of the eye and extends anteriorly from the ciliary body, lying behind the cornea and in front of the lens. It divides the anterior segment of the eye into the anterior and posterior chambers, which contain aqueous fluid. It is a circular body composed of pigment cells and two layers of smooth muscle fibers, that is, one circular layer and the other radiating layer. In the center, there is an aperture known as the pupil. Parasympathetic stimulation constricts the pupil and sympathetic stimulation dilates it. The color of this iris is genetically determined and depends on the number of pigment cells which are present. The lens. The lens is a highly elastic circular biconvex body lying immediately behind the pupil. It consists of fibers enclosed within a capsule and is suspended from the ciliary body by the suspensory ligament. Its thickness is controlled by the ciliary muscle through the suspensory ligament. This lens bends the light rays reflected by the objects in front of the eye. And when the ciliary muscle contracts, it moves forward, releasing its pull on the lens, increasing its thickness. And the nearer the object is being viewed, the thicker the lens becomes to allow focusing of this object. The retina. The retina is the innermost lining of the eye and is an extremely delicate structure well adapted for stimulation by the light rays. It is composed of several layers of nerve cell bodies and their axons lying on the pigmented layer of the pitello cells. The light sensitive layer consists of sensory receptor cells known as the rods and cones, which contain photosensitive pigments that convert light rays into nerve impulses. The retina lines about 3/4 of the eyeball and is thickest at the back of the eye. It thins out anteriorly to end just behind the ciliary body. So the near the center of the posterior part is the medulla macula lutea, or the yellow spot. In the center of the yellow spot, there is a little deviation known as fovea centralis, which consists only of the cones. And towards the anterior part of the retina, there are fewer cones than rods. About 0.5 centimeters of the nasal side of the macula lutea, all the nerve fibers of the retina converge to form the optic nerve. And the small area of the retina where the optic nerve leaves the eye is the optic disc, or the blind spot. This area has no light sensitive cells. Then let's look at the blood supply of the eye. The eye is supplied by the arterial blood by the ciliary arteries and the central retinal artery. These are the branches of ophthalmic artery, which is a branch of the internal carotid artery. Venous drainage is by a number of veins, including the central retinal vein, which eventually empties into the deep venous sinus. The central retinal artery and the vein are encased in an optic nerve, which enters the eye at the part known as the optic disc. Interior of the eye. The anterior segment of the eye is the space between the cornea and the lens, and is incompletely divided into anterior and posterior chambers by the iris. Both chambers contain clear aqueous fluid, which is secreted into the posterior chamber by the ciliary glands. It circulates in front of the lens through the pupil into the anterior chamber and returns to the venous circulation through the sclerovenous sinus, also known as the canal of Schlemm, in the angle between the iris and the cornea. In the intraocular pressure, it remains fairly constant between 10 to 20 millimeters of mercury, as production and drainage rates of this aqueous fluid are equal. An increase in this pressure causes a condition known as glaucoma. Aqueous fluid supplies nutrients and removes waste from the transparent structure in the front of the eye, which have no blood supply such as the cornea, lens, and the lens capsule. Behind the lens and filling the posterior segment cavity, there is the vitreous body. This is a soft, colorless, transparent, jelly-like substance which is composed of 99% water, some salts, and mucoprotein. It mainly maintains sufficient intraocular pressure to support the retina against the choroid and prevent the eyeball from collapsing. So the eye keeps itself because of this intraocular pressure, which is exerted by the vitreous body and the aqueous fluid, which remains very constant throughout life.